shoulder, and my other forearm's gonna slide to the crook of his elbow right here. So now the more pressure my partner puts on me, the more just kind of goes right into my frame and goes onto his throat and onto his arm. So from here, just like we did that hip escapes in the warm-up, I'm gonna plant my foot, scoop my hips out. It might be a lot of little mini hip escapes, might be a big one, might be somewhere in between, but I want to hip escape until I can get my knee inside my partner's hip here. Now from here, I can start extending away, and then we were also messing around with last week, getting a half butterfly hook, which just means I'm putting my foot through, but my outside knee stays out as well. So now this is really good framing. My forearms are both creating good frames in my upper body, and both shins are creating up frames on his lower body as well. So now I've got a lot of space that I can create with all four of my frames. From here, you can do all sorts of stuff. We can extend away, get my left leg through and just go into a closed guard, or if I rewind, you can extend away, slide to the wrist, go to a collar tie, and come right to a triangle guard as well, or I can go step by step, feet on the hips, foot on the bicep, and then going into triangle guard as well. And if you want to throw in a little bit more, you can also, again, same position here. I can now extend my hips, go to a full butterfly. Maybe he postures up. If he postures up, that's a great time to slide right into using that butterfly, those butterfly hooks, to switch to maybe a X guard, single leg X guard, or whatever you like to do from there. If they don't posture up from that butterfly guard, you may prefer, it might be better to go to a triangle or a closed guard. If they posture up, which is very common, sit up with them, and then you can get that sweep. So again, from here, if you weren't here last week, no worries. I'm framing right away, hip escape, get my knee in, get my foot in. If you can't get your foot in yet, extend first, and then get your foot in. Now I've got all four frames perfect. I can go closed guard, that's totally fine. I can go slide to the wrist, collar tie, one step or multiple steps to get to triangle guard. Or, again, we're right here. I've got all four frames, shins and forearms. And I'm just gonna slide to butterfly hooks. He sits up, I go under hooks or a full body lock. And I scoop my hips underneath him, I pull him back into me. This is a little bit more advanced if you haven't messed around with X guard or single leg X guard, but if you have, feel free to mess around with this. There's all sorts of stuff that you can do from this position, including sweeps.
Leg attacks, things like that. So let's start off with this, which is kind of a review of everything we just did last week. Recovering guard from side control right into the offense, or at least into recovering a guard. You can stop in close guard, stop in butterfly guard, you can stop in triangle guard, but don't worry about finishing triangles yet. We're going to work from triangle guard for some offense coming up after this. Let's do it. One, two.
Sun is down, freezing cold. That's how we already know when it's here. My dog will probably do it for Louis Bell. That's just all he know, he don't know nothing else. I tried to show him. Yeah. I tried to show him.
We're starting in the triangle guard already. So if you want to start maybe in this position, whatever, you want to get some more practice of coming here. Again, frames were here. I slide to the wrist and I switch to a collar tie. The reason I don't just keep this forearm frame under his head is because as the person starts to sense the triangle, if I don't have strong posture control as my legs come through, he's just gonna posture all the way away from me essentially right here. So the sooner I can be ready for that and come here now, and even if he decides from here to drive into me, I can still use my forearm as a frame as well. Maybe not quite as strong of a frame as across his neck, but still can be a good frame. But really, what I'm looking for from here, I can even switch to feet on the hips first and then foot on the bicep. He's going to be sensing a triangle pretty hard from here, and he's going to be trying to posture up. So as he postures up, that actually creates even more space for me to get my legs through, but without him fully posturing because I have that collar tie right here. So anyway, once you're here, feel free to just start in this triangle guard if you want to. His arm is always going to be on the same side rather than across my body. That's totally fine. I'll show how to finish the triangle both ways, and then also show some options if you don't like the triangle or if the triangle is not working, whatever, from here. So I've got the triangle guard. That just means I've got one arm in, one arm out of my closed guard. My legs are locked. I'm going to grab the opposite shin as soon as possible, because this does a couple things. It keeps the posture really loaded down here, so it's hard for him to get his posture back. And it also allows me to unhook my triangle guard. So I don't want to unhook and then leave a bunch of room for him to get his arm out, his left arm out, and now he's in a double underhook, maybe pass or something like that. So I want to be here, and I go straight to his hip, and I keep my knee tight. From here, I'm going to do a little bit of a scoot away, but mostly a rotation here, and I pull my calf right to the back of his neck here. My right knee stays tight, and now, even without my super long legs, I've got a decent amount of ankle sticking out past his neck, which I can then lock onto with my legs. So my knee stays tight, I come off, and then I'll lock over. I point my toes, because what we definitely don't want is to be ankle locking myself, trying to force a triangle that's kind of sloppy here. So I get my angle. This also helps a lot if I try to close a triangle on Brad from here. So much of his back and shoulders in there, it's going to be really hard, but I come all the way to his neck, so that now as I lock, I can point my toes. I point both of my toes up towards the ceiling. From here, this hand can certainly help by underhooking his arm or even his leg. I'm going to clock this foot out to start making a straight line between my shins, and then I'm going to curl my thighs together and curl my hamstrings in to get a little finish right there without even having to address that arm that's inside. So that's where I probably finish most of my triangles, with the arm on the same side, because it's quick, you can go into it right away. A lot of people will think they're maybe somewhat safe if they don't let their arm get pushed across. But sometimes maybe I come here and I can lock it here, but it's not quite tight enough to finish. From here, I'm gonna bridge my hips up and start guiding his arm across, and then put my hips back down. And then I'll even grab this knee and keep his arm clenched. So now if he tries to get that arm out, it's very hard. And then I'll grab both hands to the shin, one on the knee, one on more of the shin. And now from here, it'll be even tighter and even easier to lock up as well with his arm across. So now I point those toes again, get that angle. Use your upper body to help get that angle as well. And then again, just a steady little slow squeeze together with my thighs, and slow squeeze with the hamstrings curling my thighs as well. So you can finish the triangle with your arm across or straight. Feel free also, maybe a lot of times what the person might be doing to help avoid the triangle, or the initial triangle threat, is he overhooks my thigh with his inside arm. Exactly, this is very common, where it can be kind of hard to just triangle your way through this. So from here, try to lock it as much as you can. If you can fully lock it, maybe it's not gonna choke him, but at least it's good control. If not, triangle guard is okay. I'm gonna bridge my hips and look for this wrist. If I can get his wrist and can come over and grab my own wrist, then it's gonna be a rough night for the person on top as well. So if we can get this, awesome. I pull his elbow to my chest, and then I'm gonna rotate my whole body towards his head to get the finish. Try to keep your thumbs attached to your fingers rather than C-grips on both of these as much as possible. Try to keep his elbow bent 90 degrees as much as possible, and I just keep it all hugged into my torso and turned towards him. You can also, if you want to keep the triangle threat the whole time, keep your legs like this. If you want to go a little bit more all in for the Kimura, feel free to lock over his head, and then this leg stays right over his hips, and again, now you've got even more torque. I've got much more range of motion. I can bring his hand all the way to the back of his head right there. So Kimura option is great. And then I'm not gonna go today super deep into the omoplata, but I will throw it out there as another option for a similar scenario where he's got his arm over. Maybe I can't get much of a grip on this wrist, or I get the wrist and I can't get my arm around his arm. I'm gonna post on his head, open my legs, switch my legs, and then lock a triangle over. I like to lock a triangle over his arm and then extend and come up to my elbow and then hand, and then try to cover his lower back as soon as possible right here. Once you're here, for right now, we'll just scoop away, get his shoulder to the mat, pull both feet back as much as possible. I like to go into a little gable grip on his far shoulder. I keep his hand stuck between my hips here, and I'm just gonna slowly bridge my hips up and over towards his head direction, directly here, not across or any other direction right there. If you're brand new to omoplatas, don't worry about it too much right now. You can mess around with it a little bit if you want to, but definitely I would stick with triangles first. Otherwise, throw in that Kimura,
throwing the omoplata. Anything else that you like to do, wrist locks, whatever, from triangle guard, feel free. But let's focus on triangle guard. From there, working on different attacks, and then we'll do a little bit of defense from triangle guard. Put it all together from there. Let's do it. One, two.
Made this here with all the ice on in the booth. At the gate outside, when they pull up, they get me loose. Yeah, jump out, boys, that's Nike boys hopping our coast. This shit way too big, when we pull up, give me the loot.
Give me the loot!
Was off the rim.
So, number one thing, if you don't remember anything else that I say here as far as defending triangles, number one thing is get your posture, which means your head over your hips as soon as possible right here. So I need my posture right away. The more time against someone who's halfway decent against triangles that I spend with my posture broken, the more time or the less likely I'm going to escape, and more likely things are going to get really bad potentially really quickly. So ideally, number one, in a perfect world, if I'm able to get my posture right away, or maybe I just keep my posture the whole time so they never had my posture broken down. But if they did break down my posture to get to triangle guard, I want to bring my head up and my hips in so that my head to hips make a straight line like a tower right here. My hands will also be kind of just together and framing on his stomach right here, so that if he tries to crunch into me or tries to grab my head with his hands, it can at least be pretty tough initially here. Now from here, hopefully in a perfect world again, I can dive both arms out or both arms in. Both arms out would be better because then I can maybe pass his guard. But at least I'm not in a triangle with either of those. So again, right here, and working both arms in or both arms out is awesome at a basic level. Sometimes that posture is starting to get broken down more, and it can get tough to get into that tower position right here. So whether you start this escape that we're going to focus on today and this week, you can start it here, or you can start it in a more compromised position right here, even with him starting to lock up the triangle a little bit more. What I'm looking for is that same side wrist, and I'm going to fall to my opposite hip and look to go foot into that armpit right here. So now if he tries to sit up and pull my posture down to try to lock up that triangle further, it gets a lot tougher when he's overly extended away from me. From here, I'm gonna lean back to that hip, bring this leg over, and then lock my ankles right here. So I'm gonna close the guard around his torso. So now we've both got a closed guard more or less. This is the triangle guard, mine's just around his waist in kind of a reverse guard position. And I'm just gonna, I'm not in a huge rush at this point. It's gonna be essentially impossible for him to finish me with the triangle right here. And I'm just gonna slowly put my hip pressure into him until his guard eventually breaks. And he can, honestly, as long as there's no worry about the time limit, I prefer him to take as long as possible without going a bit, because then his leg's gonna be more and more tired. From here, at the most basic level, feel free to frame one leg away and then start escaping out, maybe hopefully get on top. Again, we're here. He's gonna wanna use his hands to improve his triangle or to break down my posture, so those hands will be in a grabbable range here. The reason why I don't just do this is because as I do this, he's gonna start swimming them away and then sweep me or just pull me straight down into the triangle. So if I just do legs only, he can swim through those legs. If I come here, now he can still start trying to swim through this leg, but I'm at least safe in the meantime. And then once I do cross these ankles, I'm gonna start putting some pressure from here. Now, depending on what you like to do from here, there's a lot of ways to just start weaving into various leg entanglements and going into all sorts of stuff from here. So you can definitely use it as a way to then not just escape the triangle, but weaving into various leg entanglements. And then again, you can also just frame a leg away and safe stance up as well if you'd rather just avoid the leg entanglements to begin with. So maybe my posture is already pretty broken. Maybe even starts locking up that triangle a little bit further here. And then try to get to this wrist and go right here. So even if it's somewhat locked up, it's still possible. If you can't pull down my head, it's gonna be hard for him to finish. Just because he's in a much more extended position. Ideally, he wants me crunched down, my posture broken, and he also wants to be crunched into me to make the triangle most effective. So this is gonna be
harder for him to finish in this position. And then once I come here, I'm gonna start leaning back and then start working into whatever from there. If you like leg entanglements, things like that, feel free to see what you can find from there. There's a lot of ways you can get to some pretty good leg entanglements. And I would say you probably have a good advantage as far as the leg entanglements compared to the other guy, especially if your legs are already a little tired from squeezing that triangle. If your posture is already high and he's trying to reach to break that posture down, you can do the same thing from good posture as well. So you may find that you like that as a go-to, whether your posture is still good or whether it's already a little later stage triangle. This style escape can work in a variety of stages as far as the triangle is going. So feel free to, again, stay stance away. Once you once their triangle guard pops open, you can stay stance up, hopefully get on top, or you can work right into entangling the legs and doing a counterattack on the legs. Let's focus on just that defense. There's a lot of ways to potentially defend and escape triangles. This is one that's new-ish for most of you guys. Question?
When you're sliding around and you're tilting your body at all?
As far as...
Like when you're up and you're here, are you to get your arm, to move your arm?
Yeah, so it'll kind of depend. If there's no space at all, I might even prefer to do this one right here, turning at an angle. This is better anyway, because now I can go into double overhooks and start looking maybe even past right off of that. So I would say keep your posture up, try to turn a little one way, turn a little the other way, see if you can find just a little bit of space depending on your body type and your partner's legs length. It's gonna kind of dictate how easy to funnel those arms in or out. And that's just a really simple way to escape a triangle guard at the very early stages. But you may prefer a little bit different escape, especially in the later stages as well. Any other questions on that? Let's go both sides if you can with your partner, starting a triangle guard and just working your way out. Mess around with that escape if you already know and like other escapes as well. Feel free to practice those. Let's do it. One, two.
Surrender, retreat. We all in too deep. Play for keeps. Don't play us a week. Surrender, retreat. We all in too deep.
This shit way too formal, y'all know I don't follow suit. Stacy Dash, most of these girls ain't got a clue. All of these hoes I made off records I produce. I might take all my exes and put them all in a group. Hit my essays, I need the booch. About to turn this function into Bonnaroo. Told her I been, you coming too. In the 305, bitches treat me like I'm Uncle Luke. Have to slot the top off, it's just a roof. She say, where we going? I set the moon. We ain't even make it to the room. She thought it was the ocean, it's just a pool. Now I gotta open, it's just a ghost. Who put this shit together? I'm the glue.
So and sad.
Shorty face, Tommy out the blue.
So and sad. So and sad, motherfucker. So and sad.
Don't play us for weak.
Astro. Yeah, yeah.
Hey, hey.
She's in love with who I am. Back in high school, I used to bust it to the dance. Now I hit the FBO with duffels in my hands. I did half a Xan, 13 hours till I land. Had me out like a light.